right here, you know, there's no other way to really me to describe this car except just by looking at it. I don't know, just screams hooligan. It's a pretty much a hooligan of a car. It's obviously a 1988 Mercedes 190E. I mean, you can just go out there and just buy it for cheap, you know. If you really want a cheap car that, you know, that's fun to drive, that has a rear-wheel drive, feels like a rear-wheel drive rocket, to be honest, with a 2.5-litre engine. I think it's a Cosworth engine, a legend of a car. Pretty sure back in the day, Mercedes spent a ton of money making this car to be as perfect as possible. I mean, manufacturers like that, that's where they gain their reputation from models like this. So, you know, to be honest, it's a legend of a car from the 80s. So whoever's got up one of these in real life, in pristine condition, they would never want to get rid of it, no matter how much money you throw at them. What I've got with this particular unit is pretty much a full drift mode setup. The only negative to it, in my view, when you're drifting it and in a competition, or, and you finish the race and it's a heat 5 situation, good luck, because escaping the cops in a drift mode setup is almost impossible. But you'll see it in the next race, what I've done and how I escape, or how I try to escape. Spoiler. But anyway, even if I get busted, I really don't care, because it's just a fun car to drive. Once I'm driving it, I just don't care about the result. All I do is just slide through the corners and, you know, put my foot down, tap the gas pedal and use the handbrake to get myself out of, you know, situations where, you know, I could possibly jump off the cliff. But it's like being on roller skates with this car. That's probably the best way to put it. Engine-wise, that's what I've got. I mean, what else do I need? Just that over 700 horsepower, newton meters just under 800, quarter mile 10.8 seconds with a, you know, drift car setup. Bloody awesome car to drive. Really, that's the only reason why I didn't get rid of it. I was thinking of getting like a Japanese, you know, S14 or whatever, S15. Something in Japanese for a drift car to win the races with, but I just can't get enough of this one. So yeah, it's a European, you know, legend, and I'll keep it that way. I mean, performance wise, yeah, I've got it at 78 drift. That's pretty much the max, I'm pretty sure. Got it at no traction control, of course. If you want to drift properly, that's what you need. And the gas step is just the way to do it. If you want to drift, you're going to get good at it. But yeah, elite level for pretty much everything. Except, I don't know why I didn't do this one, but whatever. It's the suspension that could have done elite level. You see in the race, it doesn't really make any difference at all. This car just flies through the corners. And the drivetrain, you can't get better than 7-speed. Not a big fan of drivetrains for drift. But it is what it is. But yeah, like I said, I don't care in the race if I get busted or not. When I'm in this car and driving it, this game just makes it feel so real. And I enjoy it every time. Leave it as that. And if you've got time, you get a chance, watch that next video and you'll see how I try to escape the cops in a full-on drift car. Go from there.